Hello, I'm Maruk Saeed, your microbiology guide. Let's explore in-depth micro techniques and uncover groundbreaking insight together on this educational journey into the fascinating realms of microbes.
Optikin susceptibility test. Principle, procedure, results. Table of contents. Introduction. Objectives. Principle. Requirements. Procedure. Result and interpretation. Quality control. Precautions. Applications. Limitations. Introduction to Optikin susceptibility test. Optikin, also known as ethyl hydrocuprine hydrochloride, is a derivative of quinine, which is an anti-malarial agent. Introduced by Morgenroth and Levy in 1911, Optikin was initially used as an antibiotic for treating pneumococci infections, infections caused by Streptococcus pneumoniae. Although Optikin can inhibit or kill S. pneumoniae, it is not used as a treatment. Instead, it is employed to differentiate S. pneumoniae from other ahemolytic streptococci, viridans streptococci. Streptococcus pneumoniae is a gram-positive, catalase-negative, ahemolytic, anaerobic, but aerotolerant diplococcus, belonging to the genus Streptococcus within the family Streptococcaceae in the class Bacilli. Commonly found in the upper human respiratory tract, S. pneumoniae can cause pneumonia, meningitis, otitis media, arthritis, and other infections in immunocompromised and susceptible individuals. Due to its significant role in pneumonia, it is referred to as pneumococcus. S. pneumoniae is typically located in the respiratory tract and is often isolated from respiratory samples containing diverse groups of ahemolytic streptococci, making identification challenging. In 1955, Bowen and Jeff proposed a method to differentiate S. pneumoniae from other viridans streptococci by impregnating a disc with Optikin. This method is known as the Optikin susceptibility test and is used to identify pneumococcus bacteria. Objectives: to distinguish S. pneumoniae from other ahemolytic viridans streptococci. Principle: ahemolytic streptococci produce colonies with a green-colored zone of incomplete hemolysis in a blood agar medium, making it challenging to identify S. pneumoniae among other viridans streptococci based on hemolysis and common biochemical characteristics. S. pneumoniae is the only known Optikin-sensitive viridans streptococcus. Therefore, S. pneumoniae exhibits a clear zone of inhibition around the Optikin-impregnated disc, whereas other viridans streptococci do not display a zone of inhibition around the Optikin-impregnated disc. This distinctive feature allows for the easy differentiation of S. pneumoniae from other viridans streptococci. Requirements: A. Culture, media. A 5% sheep blood. Agar plate is used as the culture medium for performing the Optikin sensitivity test. This medium is prepared by adding 5% VVI defibrinated sheep blood to a molten blood agar base medium. Composition of blood agar base: a beef heart peptone, 10.0 grams, alternatively, meat extracts, 10.0 grams, peptone, 10.0 grams, alternatively, tryptose, 10.0 grams, sodium chloride, 5.0 grams, agar, 15.0 grams, final pH, 7.3, plus 0.2 at 25 halus. Preparation of BA plate, BAP. Measure the appropriate amount of blood agar base powder or the media components and mix with the required volume of water in a conical flask or glass bottle according to the manufacturer's instructions. Stir well using a magnetic stirrer or manually, and heat to boiling to ensure all components and agar dissolve completely in water. Autoclave the flask or bottle at 121 degrees Celsius and 15 lbs pressure for 15 minutes, then let it cool to around 45 degrees Celsius. Slowly pour 5%, 5 to 10%, VivoV sterile defibrinated sheep blood into the flask containing the blood agar base while stirring constantly. Mix properly to ensure the blood is uniformly distributed in the medium, forming the blood agar. Pour approximately 25 millimoliters of the blood agar into a sterile petri plate, glass plate with a 10 centimeters diameter, and allow it to solidify at room temperature. store the blood agar plates, BAPs, in a refrigerator at 4 degrees Celsius for use up to a maximum of 2 to 4 weeks. B. Reagents. Optician impregnated disc, 6 mm disc with 5 mg of Optican, defibrinated sheep blood, for BAP preparation, McFarland standard number 0.5, composition, 1% anhydrous barium chloride, BACL2, solution, 1% sulfuric acid, H2SO4, solution, preparation of number 0.5 McFarland standard suspension, in a clean and clear test tube, add 9.95 millimolars of 1% H2SO4 solution and 0.05 mmLA of 1% BACL2 solution. See equipment, Petri plates, forceps, weighing machine, autoclave, Bunsen burner, CO2 incubator, inoculating loop, cotton swab, PPE, other laboratory materials, D. Test organism, sample bacteria, Streptococcus pneumonia, ATCC, 49619, positive control, Streptococcus mitis, ATCC, 49456, or Enterococcus, faecalis, ATCC, 29212, or Streptococcus, pyogenes, ATCC, 13384, negative control. Procedure. In a sterile test tube, prepare a bacterial suspension using well-isolated ahemolytic colonies of the sample organism. Adjust the turbidity of the suspension to match the 0.5 McFarland standards. Using a sterile inoculating loop or cotton swab, streak or spread the bacterial suspension in at least two directions over the 5% sheep blood agar plate. If S. pneumonia culture is being used for purposes other than identification, Muller-Hinton agar, MHA, can be utilized. Allow the suspension to adhere to the plate and dry by leaving it in an upright position for approximately 5 to 10 minutes. Using sterile forceps, place an Optican antibiotic disc in the area of inoculation and gently press the disc to ensure its adherence. Incubate the plate anaerobically in a 5 to 10% carbon dioxide environment at 35 degrees Celsius overnight, which typically ranges from 18 to 24 hours. After the incubation period, observe the formation of a zone of inhibition around the Optican antibiotic disc and measure the diameter of the zone. If you have watched till here, don't forget to subscribe to Family of Science Lovers. Press the bell icon button so you are always updated. Result and interpretation. If the bacterium displays a zone size of 1/14 tenim, classify it as Optican sensitive. If the zone size measures 14 mm, categorize it as Optican intermediate. If no zone of inhibition is observed, designate it as Optican resistant. Regarding identification, if the bacterium is gram-positive Kochi in pairs, catalase-negative and ahemolytic, and exhibits Optican sensitivity, report it as Streptococcus pneumoniae. If the bacterium meets the above criteria but shows Optican intermediate results, conduct the spot bile solubility test. If the bacterium is bile soluble, classify it as Streptococcus pneumoniae. If the bacterium is gram-positive Kochi, ahemolytic, and Optican resistant, report it as Viridans streptococci. Optican susceptible bacteria, Streptococcus pneumoniae, Optican resistant bacteria, S. mitis group, S. anginosus, group S. sanguinis, group S. mutans, group S. salivarius group. Quality control. Streptococcus pneumoniae, ATCC, 49619 exhibits a distinct zone of inhibition, measuring 1/14 tmim around the Optican disc. Streptococcus mitis, ATCC, 49456 or Enterococcus faecalis, ATCC, 29212 demonstrate no zone of inhibition surrounding the Optican disc. Precautions. Avoid pouring blood into molten blood agar base if its temperature exceeds 45 degrees Celsius. Pour the media into Petri plates within a sterile environment before the temperature of the molten media falls below 40 degrees C to prevent clumping. Always utilize 5% sheep blood agar for bacterial identification purposes. Position the disc approximately 25 mm away from the edge of the plate. When using multiple antibiotic discs, ensure each disc is at least 25 mm apart from one another. Applications. utilized for the identification and differentiation of Streptococcus pneumoniae from other viridins, Streptococci. Limitations. If the test bacteria exhibit a hemolysis and demonstrate intermediate susceptibility to the opticin, a bile solubility test is necessary. Occasionally, reports of Streptococcus pneumoniae resistant to opticin have been documented. For culture and incubation, a 5% sheep blood agar medium and a CO2 incubator are essential. Verification is crucial for colonies demonstrating opticin resistance or intermediate susceptibility, as they may or may not be S. pneumoniae. Due to its reliance on culture, results and interpretation require a minimum of 24 hours. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, press the bell icon button. Thank you!